Hi all, and welcome back to our Minecraft Let's Play Old World Revived. Yeah, I'm starting off today looking at this beautiful piece of obsidian. It's gorgeous. Why I'm starting off this way is because, I'm done, bitches. Oink. We got the system up and running, dudes. Dudes. Yeah, dudes. Look at down here. You only got this. Well, let's go behind the scenes and let's see what is behind there. Let's go into. Actually, I've gotten a new one. Yoink. This little guy right here.
He's an Enderman. And he can go down behind the cables. And look at the cable thingies.
Okay, let me just look. Maybe this way would be a little bit better. Hey, here we go. So yeah, right there we have that thingy that gets power from the lava engines and stuff, and we have a kinetic pipe going out here to our vanilla machines down here. And then this one right here gets power from the something else in there. Then we have some cable going up there to our interface. And of course, gotta be careful, add to our storage unit. We got all filled up with 1K storage. All chests I had, as you saw there, is now inside the system, and the only thing they have filled up is one, and four of them is, almost filled up. They got their 63 types, but still, the bytes are still more. So yeah. And we got a little bit in that one. 0000 in the five others, so yeah. Damn. And we still got our machine down here. As you can see. Cool. If you were quick enough to notice, you saw that between yesterday and today, I've become sick as hell. God damn it. Nope, I don't want to be a creeper. There we go. Yeah, if you were fast as looking at it, you saw the cable not only goes up but also over, because it's let me just go out and show it to you. God damn it, I hate being sick. What the? Huh? Oh, right. Wrong place to start. Taking inward. This would have been here. There we go. Lol. It has a interface on the back here, and all the ores that we have currently are just be configured to say, "Hey, go in here." And of course, on the back of the chest. The ender chest, there is a not an interface, but an import bus. Right back here, as you see, import bus. So, as you can see. And the quarry works. Runs all the time. Gives me lots of stuff in here. And every time an ore comes in. That's another type of copper. Oh well. Doesn't have to go and do that one with hand. Yeah, it should be sent to this one, and automatically pumped into this one, getting cooked, automatically pumped into the chest, which has the import bus, and says, nom 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 nom, I'm gonna take this, and puts it in here. So, yeah. Lovely. So, we are cleared up. Now we are going to advance our system and go with the auto crafting, which is actually just as easy. I must admit, all the auto crafting is now being done with one little machine. APPLRED. All the autocrafting is done with this one, the molecular assembler. It's pretty goddamn cool. But the downside is that you can only have as many recipes as the interface bus can hold. I'm gonna show you that again. As you can see here, crafting patterns. You can only hold these 10, I think. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, 9 patterns. That's not all that much when you really want to make something big. So, hence is where these come in. Crafting units. Crafting co-processing units. Crafting monitors. 1K crafting storage. 4K crafting storage. And all of these magical items up here. We have this molecular assembler, right? And you need to pump in power. But the cool thing about the cables that I have set up now, the covered cables here, is that they can both send and receive power and send and receive items like data. So we only need one cable for that. Normally you will need more cables if you only had like a crystal cable. You need 2 inputs, one for power and one for data input. So, because we got those big cables, we can actually cover all of the 6 sides, you know, bottom, top, and all the 4 sides around with those interface thingies. And then you have 6 times 9 patterns. But still, 6 times 9 patterns isn't all that much. So you just have to make one more. Then you have 2 times 6 times 9, and then so on and so forth. But then you begin to really hinder your system. That is where these crafting units, crafting co-processing, crafting monitors, and these crafting storage thingies comes in. Because these molecular things can only do one thing at a time. And if you say, for example, let us do a basic vanilla recipe here. A furnace. Cool. How do we make a furnace? Well, a furnace is made... by cobblestone, right? Maybe that wasn't such a good idea, because cobblestone we have tons of. That's not... Yeah. Let's just say that we didn't have any cobblestone. Well, that's not a good idea. Okay, I got another one. One that's one better. Piston. A piston is wood. Man, am I stupid. Okay, here we go. Sticky piston. You need a piston. And a slime of some kind. It doesn't matter what type. Let's say you tell the crafting system, I want to make a sticky piston. But you only have Typical. Back. But you only have one molecular assembler. The molecular assembler is going to say, okay, you want a sticky piston, I need a piston. Okay, I don't know how to make a piston. Okay, and you're telling me to make a sticky piston, but you're missing a piston. Yeah, but beside it, I say, hello, you have to plan to make a sticky piston. Why don't you make that first? The molecular assembler doesn't know how to make, how to put them together like that. For example, they don't know, oh, I need to make a piston first, then combine it with a slime, and then you get your sticky piston. Hence, also, the crafting unit, core processing, and the crafting thingy. So, when you queue up things, the storage crafting unit sends all of the materials into the storage and says, this is all the materials you will need to make a sticky piston, because I know for a fact that you need a piston. A piston needs these items, bam. Then you need a, resin or rubber or slime or whatever to make a sticky piston. And then the molecular assembler will say, oh yeah, that's right. I'm gonna take these items first and then I'm going to put the piston back into the storage, crafting storage unit, take the slime, then take the piston, combine it with the slime, and then bam, you got your sticky piston. I may have ruffled your feathers here, but actually it's not all that difficult, actually. We will need a molecular thingy here. In order to make that, we need to make these. So in order to make that, we need the inscriber here. You know what? I'm pretty sure we can do this. You know, we're going to do something else first. We're going to make the interface. The interface is made by the interface block, but the interface block is made by this. Normal glass, that, and these. Okie dokie. You know what, let's go back up here with blocks. I think the interface block is right up here. Yeah, there it is. Okay, we need an helium core and a formation core. So that's a charge or pure charge, that and that. And the helium core is nether quartz and that and that. Cool. Yeah. You know what? I should just pump all of this into my system, shouldn't I? You know what? I'm gonna make 1, 2, 3 more of these inscription thingies. That's exactly what I'm gonna do. So, yeah, be right back when I have all the components needed for all the things. See you in a bit. And we are back. Yeah. As you can see, it's a little bit different here because I have tested and tested and simply can't find a valuable, valid solution to this. There are these slots here that I don't know what to do with. Let me just try and see if there's anything here that matches that that form. There isn't. Oh, maybe here. Oh! Yeah. Okay. Okay. Yeah, well, maybe this could be a good thing, anyway. Okay. We will need the items for that. We need gold. We need redstone. We need iron. We need diamond. And we need the SIL. We need the silicon here. We need the silicon here. I'm gonna take that one. Okay. Let us figure out. Let us figure out these module upgrade thingies. Okay. Oh, we need the pure surface quartz. Luckily, I've made a ton of those. 64. Okay, what do we have here? Calculation, silicon, logic, engineering. Calculation, silicon, logic, engineering. Good. Need some of those. So, calculation, pure, and how many do we need? We need 1, 2, 3, 4 of them, right? Whoops, sorry. We need 4 of them. Which means we need 4 of these. We need 4 of these. Silicon. Pretty cool, huh? Oh, yeah, we got 20. That's cool. Okay, 4. Now we need to make 4 of these. Then we're just gonna take this guy out for just a second. 1, 2, 3. Oh yeah, by the way, I'm holding down shift as I click. Oh, doesn't matter which one, I think. Nope. Left or right shift can do. Doesn't matter which one. Bingo, 4 is made. Let's see. Oh, fucking hell. I get 2 of them per... Yeah. Oh well, then I have extra. Actually, I didn't need them all. I'm gonna have to do this. I don't know why the apply things doesn't show up here. Oh my god, I made the wrong one, didn't I? The crafting thingy is just an advanced card. It's just a basic card. Not the advanced I've made here. It doesn't matter. It's the same. It's the same processing thing that's needed. The advanced one just takes gold instead of One, two. Boom. Whoa, sorry. Weird. Crafting unit. One, two, four. Okay, let's see what happens when we plug these bad boys in. What happened? Do I have to stiff click it? No. And how do I get it in there? Okay, that's weird. Oh, it was this one. I made a crafting card. ME export bus, ME interface, ME level emitter. You're probably out there knowing how the fuck this works, and yelling at the screen, and you're a noob and you're stupid. Oh yeah. What goes into these slots up here? It looks like these, right? Or maybe they do go in, but I can't. I just can't figure out how the fuck to get them in there. Well, I'll be right back, and I will probably have that figured out. So, see you in a bit. And so, we are done. Whoa, my god. Ugh. Yeah, the things I had to go through in order to make this happen, it ain't small bits. So, we have to start, we have the silicon, the logic circuit, the engineering circuit, and the calculation circuit. Which then gives us the logic processor, the calculated processor, and the engineering processor. Whoa. In order for this to be a reality, oh my god, this is the system I had to set up. Interfaces with their own pattern. Inscriber with the matching pattern. A side of the cube here, which has the cube here. Each side can hold 20 or 30 channels, but this smart cable right here can only process 8 channels at a time. So, where we get our power? I had to plug in from the bottom into the interfaces, but that alone did not give the inscriber power, so I had to forcibly give it power from the side, and in front of the inscribers are smart cable with input buses. Import meaning into the system, export meaning out of the system. Import buses into the system, sucking out any inventory from this right here. Going down, And this is two channels, one inscriber, two inscribers, it's two channels. Going over here, taking up another channel, taking up a fourth channel. So this cable goes in here with four channels. And I am so effing lucky that I have only four channels up here, that the last bit right here is eight channels. It is the maximum that this cable can send and receive information and power and stuff like that. Sorry, remember I'm still sick as hell. So, and this cable here goes into a little grotto I've made in here with an inscriber in it, because the inscriber is made to make the big the logic processors finished. So I have an export bus here telling it to export with a crafting card, as you saw how we made that, which gives us this ability here. So it crafts when it's needed, but does not take from, if I've crafted, does not take from the stock, it crafts its own. And an export bus on the side, exporting redstone, it doesn't matter. The upgrade doesn't matter because we have so much redstone, it just exports it. So from the bottom, the side, and the top, we have an import bus with the three processor patterns. On the back, we have a power. It needs power. The cool thing about this is that it has four channels. The bottom, the side, the front, and the top. Each is a channel. So, yeah. Oh, get in here, goddammit. I know we can. There we go. And so we have a cable here with four channels. This cable here we can probably upgrade with something else, for example out here or somewhere with four more channels. And this here is our crafting machine. It has the A-P-P-L-I-E-D. It has the crafting unit at the bottom. The crafting co-processor in the middle, and on top here it has this one, the 1K crafting storage unit. I did make this one a crafting monitor, but the way this is set up, I had to place it here right underneath my crafting table. So with the crafting processing monitor underneath there where the crafting table is, would look a little bit weird. So, now we can tell it, hey, give me a, let's see, one of these. First step, this one, and this one. It says here, storage, nada, co-processing, nada. But set to automatic, we can just press start. Well, it will then send all of the items down here. Whoa. Let's see if we can't see if it lands in here. It goes through the processing of making one of these. And the cool thing about it is, this this export bus. Wait a minute. This one down here actually stores it up. So it's pretty cool. Man, it's taking a bit of time, doesn't it? Or maybe it's already done it. L-O-G. Yeah, it's already done it. It's already made a logic processor. Damn, that's fast. Okay, let's go into crafting here. Let's see, a C-A-L. Crew Crafting Asteroids, C-A-L. We got two of those, okay. What is the other one? The third one is an ENG. ENG, we got one of those, okay, cool. And we got a printed circuit, so yeah. If we were to take this one out, craft me one. Okay, apparently something is... Huh. Weird. Maybe I need to do something I think we need to tweak this one a little bit. Nope, not this one. This one. Let's see what happens now. Yeah, I need to make a crafting monitor as well. We can place right here. Place right here. So yeah, I will have a link in the description below with a more detailed step-by-step how-to for this. The video I used to make this happen. Yeah, so thank you all so very much for watching. Happy Sunday, all, and as always, catch you on the flip side.